I would like to thank Brand Bank and everybody for coming here today. I'm Muhammad Ali, lightweight. If I am elected, I'll fight like heavyweight in Washington, D.C. for you. I'm running for U.S. Congress because I would like to give back. I want to give back to the community. I want to serve the 6th District. I came to this country in 1986 when Ronald Reagan was the president. It took me 14 years and a lot of John Wayne movies to become the citizen of this country finally. And I did it the right way. I came to America because I believe in America and American dream. I'm a proud American and I believe in the liberty and justice for all. This country has given me a lot of opportunities. My family and I have benefited tremendously. So this is my turn to give back to the community, and make sure that this country moves in the right direction. As an economist, I understand what needs to be done. As a concerned citizen, I understand what needs to be done. So on April 18th, I hope you will consider voting for me. I'm at the top of the ballot, Muhammad Ali. You cannot miss it. Thank you so much.
Hello, my name is David Abrams. Tell you real briefly about myself. I'm a CPA by training. I was a tax accountant for about 3 years, and then I started a business converting vehicles to run on clean domestic natural gas. So I did that for about 6 years. And now I've ventured into politics. And the reason why I decided to run in this race is because I think we have some serious challenges in this country. I think that in Washington, we just mentioned about the low approval rating of Congress. And that's because there's too much fighting, there's not enough talking, there's not enough trying to actually solve problems for the people of this country. It's all about politics and one-upping people. Now, I am a conservative. I believe in free markets, limited government. I think the market forces are the best thing to improve the lot of the ordinary man. Milton Friedman is probably one of my biggest mentors. I believe in these principles very deeply. But that being said, in order to govern effectively, it cannot be a blood sport. We have to be able to find ways that we can work together and solve these challenging problems in Washington. Our debt is absolutely under control, and if we don't do something about that, if we don't do something about tax reform, if we don't do something about healthcare, these are serious problems, and we are going to leave the next generation worse off, and I'm not prepared to do that. I'm prepared to go to Washington and stand up for liberty and fight for these principles that are so important to us, but also work together. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Karen Handel, and I want to add my thanks to Brand Bank and to the various chambers who are sponsoring today. I think we've had a lot of talk out of Washington, and what we need is a doer, someone who is going to go to Washington and actually deliver for you. I have a track record of delivering and getting things done. Many of you in this room know me. You know that my career is anchored in the private sector. I took those skills to the Fulton County Commission, where I faced a $100 million budget deficit, balanced it without a tax increase, when few thought I could, and did that without a Republican majority. When you gave me the privilege of being your Secretary of State, I was able to get photo ID implemented, and today that law, photo ID, stands as one of the best examples of election security in this country. That's the kind of leadership that I'm going to take to Washington. Someone who is going to deliver, finally, on repealing and replacing Obamacare, on tax reform, securing our borders, reducing taxes, and finally getting a balanced budget and taking on this debt. So I look forward to answering the questions. Thank you so much for this opportunity.
Good morning, everybody. Thank you, Wes. Thanks to Brand Bank and the participating chambers and everyone who's here to hear from the candidates. My name is John Ossoff. I'm a native son of Georgia, went to Georgetown University's School of Foreign Service, where I studied international relations. I worked on Capitol Hill for 5 years, specializing in defense and national security policy. Saw the legislative process, saw how constituent service and congressional oversight can be rendered, and also saw why Washington is broken, the corruption the partisanship, the gridlock, decided to leave. In 2012, I got a master's degree from the London School of Economics, and now I run a small business that specializes in anti-corruption and organized crime investigations, producing documentary films for major international broadcasters. I am running a positive campaign that is focused like a laser on our local economic development. The high-tech, biotech, and medical research sectors can make North Metro Atlanta the Silicon Valley of the South if we can get beyond partisanship and focus on solutions like expanding export markets, cutting wasteful spending, prioritizing research and development. And a member of Congress can also be an ambassador for our business community, attracting new facilities, headquarters, and research centers from growing organizations. And I would be honored to serve you in that capacity in Congress. Thank you.
I'm Dan Moody, and I was first elected as a conservative Republican to the Georgia State Senate in 2002. I had been an Army officer. I had owned my own business. I had helped create some great Georgia jobs, and I pumped millions of dollars into our economy, just like some of you have. I had always wanted to have an opportunity to become a public servant. And in 2002, Georgia became a red state. But you know what happened? A lot of people realized it was time to govern. And new leaders emerged at the Capitol. And I was one of them. My caucus elected me as their chairman. I helped do a lot of hefty lifting. And together, we took a huge surplus that we had inherited from the Democrats, over $600 million, and we turned it into a $500 million surplus. I had always believed in term limits. And you know what I did? After four terms, I term limited myself. I went home to live under the laws that I helped create. And today in Washington, it's time to govern. And folks, we've just got to get it right. Because if we don't, as Republicans, we may never get another chance. I'm all for hard work. I learned how to do it in the Army, and I'm ready to do it again. But one thing you won't get from me, I'll never be a career politician. I really want to earn your vote. Thank you.
Good afternoon. How's everyone doing today? Good, good. My name is Reagan Willard Edwards. I currently reside in the 6th District in East Cobb, and I actually graduated high school in East Cobb as well. Then got the Hope Scholarship and went to Georgia Tech. Moved up to D.C. and worked for a presidential appointee as well as for the Department of Energy. Currently, I work at a global financial services firm that deals with big data. And I've had a lot of time and I have a lot of understanding about the technological landscape that we're currently living in. I'm currently a member of the ACLU, TAG, the Technology Association of Georgia, and I have been for a while, Women in Technology, as well as the Sales Management Association. I'm a professional and I'm a mother of two girls. I say all this to tell you that I have perspective. I understand what it means to buy the milk and to work in corporate America. I understand what businesses need to thrive, and that's what I want to give to those business owners of the 6th District. I want you to continue to thrive, and I want you to soar. So on April 18th or before, definitely put your vote in for Reagan Edwards, because I'm here for you.
Thank you, Reagan. We're going to go to table one here. We're going to go to Keith Brower. Keith.
Hi, thanks everybody for being here today. My name is Keith Brower, and I'm running for Congress because I believe we desperately need leaders in Congress of courage and integrity. So I'm originally from Dunwoody. I graduated from Marist and then went to Duke University. While there, I joined the Air Force ROTC program, and after graduation, I became an officer in the Air Force, went to pilot training in Valdosta, and have been flying airplanes in the Air Force for about 14 years, up until I became a candidate. I've lived all over the country. I've lived all over the world, including Korea and Eastern Europe, where I worked with NATO. And I flew 497 combat sorties in Iraq and Afghanistan during four deployments. And I did all that because I believe in the nobility of serving a cause greater than yourself. And that's what I think we're desperately missing in Washington. You know, we need fighters who are going to stand up to the special interest, who are going to fight to control the growth of government, and who are going to make the hard decisions that are necessary to move America forward. And until we start electing different people, people who have the values to stand up for those principles, I think we're going to continue to see congressional approval at 19 or 12%. Thank you very much. The name is Keith Broward.
Hi, I'm Andre Pollard, and I'm running as an independent for Congress. I am a technologist. I am part of the resist movement. I got up off my sofa and feeling of helplessness, I decided that I'm going to, you know, run for Congress, and I hope my run is inspirational to others that anyone can run for Congress. I'm a father of four kids. I'm an immigrant. I immigrated here when I was 11 years old. My wife is Latino from Dominican Republic. I am all of you. I run the Alpharetta Ventures and Incubator Meetup Group, which meets in the Alpharetta Technology Center. And we have a startup coming out called WorkAlert.com. I'm a mechanical engineer. I work for a large telecom company. And my main goal is to get more women in technology, more legacy force in technology, promote the American brand, defend the American brand from anyone, promote startups and small businesses, and develop those future skills for a technology future. Thank you.
My name is Bob Gray, and quite candidly, I'm running to save the American dream. When I was a boy, my grandparents imprinted on me three fundamental American values: self-reliance, independence, and personal responsibility. And as I watch TV and go about my day, I see that we as a country have drifted so far from those American values, and I think the solution is to change the way we do business in Washington, D.C. I grew up in Buffalo, New York, Rust Belt kid, went and had graduated from Purdue University with an engineering degree, went to the University of Chicago, received my MBA in finance, spent the next 30 years in the technology industry, on the management team of multi-billion dollar companies. I now have invested in a local startup. I know as a member of that board what it is to risk your own capital and to struggle to make payroll. Very different skill set than that when you're working for a global 1,000 company. So I have both perspectives. What I want to do is focus on results in D.C., and we're just not seeing that happen for the American people. Economic issues, the debt, and national security. I have a particular interest in cybersecurity. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Ron Slotin. I served two terms in the Georgia State Senate. I was on the Education Committee and I helped pass the HOPE Scholarship. And I see a sleight of hands of how many families have been helped by the HOPE Scholarship in this room. That was the best program that the state's ever passed, and I'll remind you that we had a Democratic governor, Democratic state house, and Democratic state senate when we passed that legislation. We got a lot of things done when I was in the state senate. We lowered state taxes. We gave teachers the pay raise they deserve. We grew the economy. We expanded the World Congress Center. I worked with the Metro Chamber of Commerce to bring infrastructure improvements to Atlanta for the Olympic Games. These are the issues that the Democratic Party needs to run on. After politics, I opened a business in Sandy Springs. I had an advertising agency. I helped start the Sandy Springs Chamber of Commerce. When I was with my advertising agency, I was part of the business development team that created the 2009 entertainment tax credit that has resulted in thousands of jobs in the state of Georgia. Just in 2016, there was over 240 TV and movie productions generating over $7 billion in economic development. I have a record of results. A lot of people talk about doing things. I have a record of results for creating jobs, growing the economy, improving our education. It doesn't matter if you're a Democrat, independent, or Republicans. Those are issues that affect everybody in the district. Those are issues that will help people in the district, and those are issues that I'm going to get results on. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Amy Kramer. I am a former flight attendant and real estate agent and one of the founders of the Modern Day Tea Party movement. I'm not the party of no. I want common sense conservative solutions in Washington, D.C. And I'm running because I got involved, I guess, about 8 or 9 years ago when I was sick and tired of yelling at my TV and radio, and I got off my couch and decided to do something about it. And this movement started across the country. I feel like Washington is out of control. The federal government has gotten too big. They're more and more involved in our lives. And this country is exceptional. The people are exceptional. What nobody talks about anymore is opportunity. We need to get the government out of our lives and let the American people and our small businesses thrive. And I think that we are headed that direction under President Trump. But I think we need more citizen legislators in Washington, D.C. As I travel across the country, I've encouraged others to go out there and run. And when Tom Price was appointed HHS secretary, and I've lived in this district my entire life, I was born in Kennestone Hospital and lived here my entire life, how can I go out and encourage others to do something if I'm not doing it myself? I would like to see a woman elected to the seat, because the GOP, to my knowledge, has never elected a woman to a federal seat nor to governor. And I think it's time that we need more women in Washington, D.C. One thing about women is we don't sit around and talk about how to get things done. We just go out and do it. And that's what I want to do.
Ron, I think that was a good idea to stand up. We're used to standing up at all these, so forgive me. My name is Kurt Wilson, candidate for the 6th Congressional District. There's a lot of outstanding people on this stage, and if I were sitting in your shoes, I'd be saying, who do I vote for and why? And so let me give you my bio. It's incredibly impressive. I'm an ordinary citizen just like you. And that's significant, because everyone in this room knows the one obvious truth, and everyone on this stage knows the one obvious truth. Washington, D.C. is badly broken, and it's got to be fixed. And it can't be fixed on the margins. It's got to be fixed with a reformation of big ideals, a reformation that we have to reverse the $20 trillion of national debt, a reformation that we have to begin balancing the budget with a surplus, a reformation that we have to repeal the 16th Amendment and replace it with a flat tax or a fair tax, a reformation, most importantly, that we have to derail and defund the federal bureaucracy and return the power back to the people. So I'm running for one simple reason. It's to get the government off the backs of the people. My name is Kurt Wilson. Thank you.
We're going to go down to table 3 with Alexander Hernandez.
Hello, everyone. My name is Alexander Hernandez, and I am the only truly independent out of the field of 18 candidates here. Meaning, I've already put the district before Nancy Pelosi and Paul Ryan, and I mean it. I ran on a People First platform, but I'm glad to see there's bipartisanship happening with both Mr. Gray and John here trying to buy the election. We're doing it a little different, and our People First platform does that. We make sure that we focus on the economy first and foremost. And how do we do that? We invest in people through infrastructure and education. Infrastructure for jobs now, education for growth into the future. We follow what President Dwight D. Eisenhower did with the interstate system. We have poisoned waterway systems, roads, bridges that all need upgrading, and that's a lot of jobs we put people to work right now. Second point, we look at our veterans and we give them a raise. And how are we gonna pay for it? Cutting the waste at the Pentagon. Over $6.5 trillion has been lost over there over the past 10 years, and Congress has not lifted a finger. If I go to Congress, I will make sure we start finding that money and we hold people accountable. Congress should check the purse, and I will make sure we do it. And then finally, healthcare. Healthcare's been in the news lately. The thing is, the partisans won't tell you is they're not gonna go after the real problem. It's just band-aid solutions and kicking the can down the road. Both failures of plans, the ACA was a failure, it's Heritage Foundation's plan. Our plan focuses on the people. Right now, today, we could repeal and replace Obamacare with HR 676. It's in Congress right now, it's been introduced. We pass that, repeal, replace, we lift the burden off of small businesses from providing health care, stimulate the economy, and boost, and it helps everyone. YourVoteGeorgia.com is my website, and I hope I can count on y'all's support. Thank you.
Alexander Hernandez, first one to start heating things up. Thank you for that. Richard Keighley.
My name is Richard Keighley. I'm running for change, change in the form and content of our political discourse. I think like a lot of people here, I've been frustrated by the partisan bickering and the lack of concrete results. I am not a politician, but I have always been a public servant. I spent 7 years in the United States Navy as a naval officer serving my country, first on a surface warfare ship and then in Naples, Italy. In the Navy, I learned two lessons. One was the strength of our nation's great diversity, and the other was the importance of America's role in the world as a force of stability and democracy. And I intend as a congressman to defend those two principles. As your congressman, I would emphasize, for the past 12 years, I've been an educator. I teach at Georgia State University. I teach Italian and French. I did my PhD eventually at Yale University. I, as your congressman, would concentrate on three things: education, national security, and the jobs of the future. I think these three aspects are the things that we most need to concentrate on in the 6th District and as a country. In education, of course, we know our high schools are behind other schools in this country, in Georgia, and the United States is behind other countries in the world. And we need a strong education to enable our democracy and our economy to move forward. In the 6th District, I would create a jobs leadership task force involving the different communities that are now separate and try to work toward creating the jobs of the future. I'm Richard Keefe from Tucker, Georgia. Thanks.
Hi, I'm Judson Hill. I'm a senator and legislator, citizen legislator, and I've served many of y'all for a number of years, but I've also been a small business owner, and I served with President Reagan in the White House. And through those years, I've learned about the issues that are important to you, because America is struggling, and the families and the businesses of this community are really struggling. America, I believe, is at a crossroads, a major crossroads. But I think we need a conservative reformer who can stand up for you every single day. We need a trusted reformer, a trusted conservative, someone who has the principles and the values that you represent, someone who stood up for you to defend those values in the face of special interest and the political establishment, been punished because they stood up to defend your values. I think it's time that we send someone back to Washington, D.C. that has that proven record and track record. You know, everyone before you is going to stand and say what they'll do, but before you listen to them, before you vote for them, make them prove to you. Make them show you what they have done. Make them show you what they have done. What have they done with tax policy and regulatory policy and immigration and standing up for our military? What have they done for you with Obamacare? Because the difference in this race is there's only one person, and that's me. I'm a trusted, principled, conservative reformer. I've advanced those measures. These are serious measures that are critically important to you. I've always put you first. If you remember two things today, remember this. You have a proven conservative reformer, someone who stood up to defend those values. And Fox News showed that I'm the only Republican who can beat the Democrat, and Nancy Pelosi is coming to take the seat back. Thank you very much.
Hello, I want to thank you all for inviting me today and speaking before you. My name is Dr. Rebecca Quigg. I'm a cardiologist and heart transplant specialist. I'm a lifelong patient care advocate and an expert on the Affordable Care and health care reform. Throughout my 25 years of practicing medicine, I saw things deteriorate with insurance coverage. People started with getting the same care, irrespective of their socioeconomic group and whether they had insurance or not. And by the 2000s, if you had a stub toe, you could not get insurance because that was a pre-existing. I left my full-time job to start a consulting business and care for my son with disabilities. I was not insurable for 5 years until I was able to purchase an ACA policy. I followed this law as it was passed through Congress. I helped enroll people, and I've seen what's happened to the Affordable Care Act over the last 4 years. There have been so many things that could have changed and amended, but the Congress was in gridlock and refused to do so. What I want to do is go to Congress with my experience and background in the healthcare reform to work in a bipartisan way to improve this law. We need to get premiums, deductibles, prescription drug prices down for individuals, families, businesses. We need to make Medicare stronger, not a voucher system. And you need a doctor in the house that knows the background as to how to do this, because we don't have enough doctors there, and I believe we need a woman doctor in the house to do this. Thank you.
My name is Bruce Lavelle, and I'm running for the Georgia 6th Congressional District. And I wish I had a lot more time, but I'll just get straight to it. I'm running because of government overreach. My family, my business, some of the small business, I recognize a lot of bankers that have been moved around from various banks. I was a victim of government overreach, part of the TARP money that caused a catastrophe in my household. And one of the reasons why it was a catastrophe, because a lot of our elected officials and our leaders were on the take with special interests, and they did nothing to help the people except help themselves. I am the candidate that will publicly disavow all PACs, especially Club for Growth. I will not take money from lobbyists. There's nothing on my campaign, nor am I trying to self-fund like some other guys trying to buy the seat. I'm absolutely, totally clear of any appearance of impropriety. I will fight for you. I know what it feels like for some of you folks that went through 2008 crash and trying to rebound. I recognize a lot of y'all that are trying to come out of that catastrophe. The one thing I bring, I started with President Trump in 2015. I know him very well. I know all the folks in the White House. I want to fight for you to bring those transportation dollars. 285 and 400 and I-85 corridor is rated the worst corridor in the nation. I was a chairman at MARTA. I have a tremendous amount of experience on all types of boards. The list goes on. I see the time's up. But I'm the candidate. You will have to worry about me. I'm not on the take for anyone. And that's Bruce Lavelle. You can Google me, Bruce Lavelle, and you'll see everything about me. I'm an open book. Thanks for having me. Thank you.
Bruce. Last but not least, Ray Locke.
I want to recognize Brand Bank. Thank you and the chambers for putting this together. I'm William Locke. I'm running the 6th District. I am not a career politician. Rather, my career has led me to politics. I'm the best candidate for the job because I've spent over 30 years as a small business owner, as a licensed CPA, advising small business owners and Americans. I am completely aware of how middle-income Americans are paying the most tax. I was born right here in the 6th District. I'm the middle brother of 11 siblings with 62% Republicans and 38% Democrat in my family, as well as our district. Our dinner conversations get quite problematic, yet, in the end, an agreement and understanding is reached. I learned at a very early age to work with others and negotiate issues. My number one goal as a CPA is to reduce taxes and regulations. I will be able to serve as your congressman as a bipartisan candidate, with both sides of the coin being discussed and studied. A decision will be reached with compromise and good results for both sides. I am the only candidate that has details on where I stand on real issues facing our district and our country. Please visit my website, search LLOP, LLOP for Congress. Thank you.